So it is very difficult to explain why some things are considered auspicious and some things are considered inauspicious. These are ancient traditions that have emerged, but we can speculate. For example, gold is considered Suvarna, the good color. And this good color is the color of the sun, because all life comes from the sun. If the sun didn't exist, then the plants wouldn't produce food, and then the animals wouldn't survive on plants, and the whole nature wouldn't exist. All life really comes from the sun, and the sun's color is considered Suvarna. It is this golden color associated with turmeric. Turmeric is considered to be Suvarna. Harvest is Suvarna. It's a golden color. The tiger skin is considered Suvarna. Hanuman, the monkey who brings good fortune to Ram, is said to have a golden skin, therefore Suvarna. And therefore, gold color has become somehow associated with life, energy, positivity, good fortune, fertility, and perhaps it is the color of the gods. They say the gods are golden colored, and therefore, when you bring gold into the house, you're bringing the golden goddess or Lakshmi into the house. Perhaps that is the reason why gold is considered auspicious. Another reason could be that gold is the perfect symbol of a very central Indian concept called Atma or the soul. If you read Vedanta, they will say that every living creature has a soul and the whole cosmos is animated by the soul. What is the soul? When somebody has described the soul, they will say the soul is very pure and it takes various forms. And gold is something like that, right? Gold is completely pure. It cannot be contaminated, unlike silver or copper. Other metals get contaminated with time when exposure to the elements. Gold doesn't get contaminated. You put it in fire, it purifies even further. The more you beat it, it is very resilient. It is very malleable and ductile, just like the soul. And you can give it different shapes and forms, you know, turn it into a earring, turn it into a necklace, turn it into a nose ring, turn it into a toe ring. So different ornaments, but ultimately when you melt them, they become gold. So the sages would say that, you know, you see so much diversity on earth. You see plants, you see animals. These are all various ornaments, which when smelted and melted will become gold, the Atma. So gold was used to explain the Atma. And perhaps that's why gold became the symbol of auspiciousness. And these are the thesis, of course. But for everyone, when you say gold, you know, there's a very famous proverb. The wise man and the sage is like gold, because no matter how many times you hit them, they will survive. They are malleable, ductile, and they're resilient. So gold's resilience, gold's purity, all makes it auspicious.